Hi, my name is Isranstino and I'm a web developer and I want to show you how you can create your own Blogger clone using PHP, JavaScript and MySQL. So here is our complete Blogger clone. So you are looking at the admin interface and from here you can see the list of posts which is posted on the blog. I will show you the blog later, but let me show you the interface first. So as you can see, we have this page views count right here as well as the comment, and you can use this button to go to the pages to see the list of posts, and you can use this button to make post draft, publish and delete the post by selecting the post from here. And you can also create a new label. Label is just a categories. And let me show you the draft page. From here you can see the list of draft posts, and this is our published posts page. So here's our list of published posts. And also let me show you the stats page. From here you can see the page views, today page views, yesterday page views, last month and all time page views as well. And from here you can see the posts by page views, which is basically viewed on the blog, and the reference sites as well, from where user visit this blog. And let me show you the pages as well. So we have this pages section right here. Let me scroll down. So we have this pages section, same as the posters. So we have this page right here, the page views as well. And we have this audience section to display audience based on the country, as you can see. Page views based on the countries, as you can see. And you can use this button to display page views based on this date. And let me show you the comment section. So this is a basically published comment on the post, in this post on our blog. And we also have the pending comment, and you can also delete this comment if you want from here. Let me show you the pending comments page. And from here you can see the list of pending comments, and you can make them publish right from here. You can just click on the publish button right here and it will publish the comment, as you can see. And now let me show you the pages section. This pages section, we have this page. You can create the page, delete the page and make them draft. And also we have a draft section for the page and the publish section for the pages. And this is our layout section of the blog. From here you can edit the gadget or add the gadget. In Blogger, you may already know Blogger has the gadgets to display on the blog. So this is our list of our gadgets display on the sidebar, on the footer, on the header and the nav. You can edit this by clicking on this edit link. It display right here the new window. From here you can edit the gadget just like the Blogger, and you can add a new gadget by clicking on this add gadget link, and you can choose gadget to add on the sidebar. And let me show you this gadget, what I mean. So go to your blog, you can just click on this view blog link right here, and we have the unique subdomain, as you can see, just like the Blogger. So every blog has a unique subdomain, and in this course you will learn how to create subdomain for the blog and redirect every blog to the subdomain. So here's our blog, this is our blog. We have the list of posts and we have the gadgets right here on the sidebar, which displayed on right here. As you can see, the search gadget, about me gadget and the follow me on the Twitter right here, as you can see. And let me also show you the footer gadgets right here. We can display gadgets on the footer right from here. As you can see, we have these gadgets on the footer. And we can also change the position of the gadgets. Let me show you. Let's say we want to change the position of this gadget to our profile gadget. So we can change that by going to our layout, and we can simply drag this gadget and move to the about me gadget. And as you can see, it switch places just like the Blogger. Of course, we can drag and drop the gadgets in the layout section, and you will learn this as well. And click on the save arrangement buttons right here, click on OK, and as you can see, the position of the gadget has been saved. You can verify that by going to your blog, refresh this blog, and as you can see, the position of the gadget has been changed. Here's our search gadget. And now let me show you the post. When you click on this post, here's our post. As you can see, you can create this post. We also have an editor for the post. But first, let me show you the editor for the template, for the whole blog template, just like the blogger. Go to the template section. And from here, you can see the HTML code of our live blog right from here. So we created a function to display our HTML code of this blog right inside here. And we created a template engine, little template engine, very simple template engine to create these shortcodes to display the blog data. So when user want to create their own blog, let's say their own blog using the HTML CSS, user can do that. But users simply add the title of the blog if user want to display, header if user want to display, the posts, the sidebar, and the footer. So we created a simple template engine to display this section on the blog, which basically make it easier for the user to make a template right from here. And let's use this editor to make changes on our live blog right here. So let's say we want to edit our blog right above here. We want to add a h1 tag right above our posts. So right above here we can just add h1 tag and we'll say update it and click on the save template button and it refresh the page. Let me zoom out and refresh this blog, and as you can see it updated our template right from here. So we successfully updated our template. And let's say we accidentally delete this template code and save the template and refresh this template, the blog. And as you can see, our template is blocked. We can restore the template by clicking on this revamp to draft button. Click on OK, OK button. And as you can see, our template is restored. Now we can refresh this page. And as you can see, it restored our template. And you will learn this template section as well. And let me show you the settings section. From here you can change the title, description, meta tag, and the limit of the posts as well, and the custom error, the comments, and you can also edit your profile from here. So there is many more things I can't show you in just one video. You can just read the description of the blog. And let me create a new post. So we can create a new post right from here. We can just click on this new post button and we have this editor for the new post. Let's say this will be our new post and we'll say using PHP. I don't know, just for example purpose. And we can go to our blog, blog post, and here's our blog post. We can just copy this post from here. I'm not going to write this post again and paste right here, and we can just select an image right here by clicking on this image icon, and we're going to upload new image and we're going to make it to center and make it to large image, and we can choose the label from here, the categories, and as you can see it automatically generates the link of the post right here, and you can create your own link by clicking on this custom Paramount link right here. And you can also update your description, post description. So let's say post, and you can also disable the comments right from here if you want. So let's click on the publish button, and you can also save the post if you want. Let's click on the publish button, and as you can see it created the new post, and we can go to our blog, go to our blog. And right here, as you can see, it created a new post. Click on that. And we have this post, as you can see. So it successfully created the post. And let me also show you the other post with the comment. We also have the feature to display the comment. Let me scroll down. So we have this comment feature. User can comment on the blog with the reply, as you can see. So there's a lot of things I can't just cover in this one video. So, and you can also edit your blog post, delete, and everything you want to do. So that's going to be it for this introduction. So what you are waiting for? Enroll now and learn how to you can create your own blogger clone using PHP, JavaScript, and MySQL. And I hopefully see you in the next lecture.